Did you know that Microsoft is still doing business with car manufacturers? Sammy from the MCVP team, Microsoft Connected Vehicle Platform team, is here to tell us everything about what's going on there. Hi everyone, thanks for watching the IoT Show. I'm Olivier, your host, and today we have Sammy from the Microsoft Connected Vehicle Platform, who's here to talk to us about the Connected Vehicle Platform. Sammy, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Tell us a bit about yourself first. Who are you? Where are you coming from? What is your team doing?
My name is Sammy. I've been at Microsoft a bit over 20 years. I come from the Azure IoT Mobility team. That's a team within Azure that comprises both the Connected Vehicle Platform team mm-hmm. and the Azure Maps team.
Can you tell me in a nutshell, why is that team part of the Azure IoT group?
Automotive in general, vehicles are really an application of IoT. It's essentially, we do IoT for things that move is how we describe what we're doing.
Got it.
An additional value add that the Connected Vehicle Platform provides on top is that we envision vehicles not just as a set of IoT devices that happen to be moving around in the same direction all the time, mm-hmm. but that they actually roll up to the single logical notion of a vehicle.
Awesome. So we had recent announcements about partnerships with Volkswagen, with Renault-Nissan. Mm-hmm. So I'd like to understand a bit better. In the past, Microsoft has been trying things or developing system and solutions for mm-hmm. for car manufacturers. Yep. And we had infotainment systems in cars that were branded Microsoft and so on. Are we doing the same?
We're doing something quite a bit different than that. So the approach that underpins the Connected Vehicle Platform is very much partner-led. Really, any vehicle that you see out on the road is the result of dozens, if not hundreds, of partnerships lined up by the OEMs to, at the end of the day, spit out a car. Mm-hmm. We are aligning ourselves with that approach. So working with partners that handle things such as OTA, delivering binary updates, software updates to the car, okay. Connectivity to deliver actual network connectivity to the internet from the vehicle mm-hmm. In order to round out a complete solution. So we very much think of and talk to partners and OEM customers as MCVP being a partner-led approach.
Okay, and what are the kind of scenarios that the platform allows these car manufacturers to implement?
Sure. So let's see. We do from basic telematics scenarios, so delivering location, speed, different vehicle status messages mm-hmm. up to the cloud, so that analytics can be performed and your typical fleet management applications can be built.
Okay.
Now, on top of that, there is an entire class of scenarios which involve not from vehicle to cloud, but from cloud to vehicle. Mm-hmm. These include things such as command and control. So a lot of the scenarios that have recently been popularized, where you have a mobile app on the device, mm-hmm. You invoke some function such as unlocking the doors or honking the horn, and MCVP arranges for those commands to be delivered down to the vehicle.
Okay.
Now, those sorts of things are not new. What we are doing is providing the connectivity platform so that the OEMs can focus on the scenario. They can focus on building the mobile app, they can focus mm-hmm. on the experience, things around connectivity, delivering those messages down mm-hmm. to the vehicle, providing a straightforward way to provide software updates down to the vehicle, those are handled by us. That's the value add.
Got it. So yeah, they can definitely, and it's the same messaging we have for overall platform at Azure IoT, which is we're simplifying this plumbing, which is complex, complicated, and hard to maintain, hard to build.
Yep.
Security is part of it as well, right?
It's a huge part of it. So we have very specific recommendations on how the connection to the vehicle is secured, how devices and vehicles are provisioned and deprovisioned.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the messages that the OEMs have really responded to and resonated with is that unless the OEM tells their customer, unless they tell the driver of their vehicle that Microsoft technology is underpinning certain aspects mm-hmm. of that experience, the consumer will not know. So there will not be a Microsoft-branded piece of hardware sitting in the vehicle.
Okay.
When the vehicle starts up in the IVI display in that mm-hmm. center sac screen, you will not see a Microsoft logo. It's really up to the OEM to decide the manner in which they want to customize and differentiate that experience mm-hmm. For their customers.
Awesome. What are the technology that you guys are using from the offer that Azure IoT has? Like some names of the technologies that our audience is using these products, and they're always interested in where these products are ending at the end of the day.
Sure. So if you were to look, and I think the question may be better phrased, which ones are we not using? If you were to do an MCVP deployment into your Azure subscription, and then you went and looked through the Azure console, you would see a number of resource groups, and then you'd see something like 35 to 40 30 constituent Azure services that we bring together in order to make up MCVP. Those include things like IoT Hub, Event Grid, Azure Data Lake, Service Fabric. There are a number of them that are in there. Key Vault, many of them. So
So all of them. So it's a it's a perfect illustration of what can be done leveraging the Azure IT services.
It absolutely is, and that's a big part of the message that we give to OEMs and potential partners, which is we say to them, you know, connected vehicle solutions themselves are not new. What we've done, as you mentioned earlier, is we've taken the plumbing, we've taken the thing, the undifferentiated heavy lifting that is common across a lot of these things. We've done it themselves, we've done it at global scale. We point out that Azure has this global coverage and this incredibly fast network interconnect. We've taken that all and put it into the platform so that they can focus on the scenarios that differentiate them from their competitors.
And we help them customize the platform to their needs, as you were saying.
We absolutely do,
Awesome. Before we give some call to action to our viewers, are there any cars today that actually are powered or equipped today? Or is it coming soon?
Vehicles are rolling off the assembly line right now. We are maintaining active counts of how many vehicles are out there live today connected via MCVP. It's in the low hundreds of thousands today.
So is the team actually sweating or excited?
Very excited. Definitely very excited.
I'm sure you guys are. Yeah. Awesome. Sammy, thanks a lot for that introduction of MCVP.
Thanks very much for having me.
So people, if you want to directly land into that webpage, learn more about what Microsoft is doing for connected vehicle, go to aka.ms/IoTshow/MCVP, like Microsoft Connected Vehicle Platform. Sammy, you will be back for actual demos of how all of that looks like, right?
Yes, I will.
Awesome. Thanks, Sammy.
Yep.
Thanks, everyone, for watching.